Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys how we can create a reset button in Java, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Well, hello again. By popular demand, many of you have been asking for a way to create a reset button of sorts for your game. I thought I might take some time to explain how to do so with a separate video. This is not a one-size-fits-all approach. You may need to make some modifications to accommodate your specific game or other application. We're just going to be pretending that we're creating a game. So this is how to create a reset button. So let's begin. We'll need a total of three classes for this example. We have a class called main. Let's create another class. File, new, class. I will call this GameFrame. Click finish. GameFrame will extends JFrame. And we will need an import. Let's create the constructor for GameFrame. So at the top, GameFrame. And we will also implements the action listener interface. Include the imports that you need, and we'll need to add any unimplemented methods. And lastly, we'll need one more class. So go back to file, new, class, and this class will be called game. Finish, and game will extends JPanel. And create the constructor for your game. So when you create a new game, you just call the constructor for this game. So within our main method, let's call the constructor to create a game frame instance. So within the main method, new game frame. And that's it for this class. And within the game frame class, we have a few things that we need to do. So at the top, we're going to declare a game. Game. We're not going to instantiate it yet. We'll get to that within the constructor of GameFrame. And we'll also need a reset button. J button. And we'll call this reset button. And within the GameFrame, we'll finish setting up the frame that we have. This is referring to this instance of our GameFrame. This dot set default close operation, then JFrame exit on close. We'll set a size, this.setSize. Pick whatever dimensions you want. I will set this to be 600 by 500. I'm going to use no layout manager, this.setLayout, and I will set this to null. Then at the end, this.setVisible, and set this to true. All right, well, our frame is taken care of. Let's work on the reset button next. We'll finish instantiating this reset button between the setLayout method and the setVisible method. So between these two lines, we'll finish instantiating the reset button. Reset button equals new J button. I'll make some modifications to this reset button. Reset button.setText. I will set this to reset. Since we're using no layout manager, we'll want to set a size and location. I'm going to use the setSize method. I will set a size of 100 by 50 and a location. Set location. Let's say 0 and 200. That should be decent. And we need to add an action listener. Add action listener. Since we're implementing the action listener interface, we can just pass in this, and then we should be good. All right, so after we create our reset button, we're going to create an instance of our game class that we have. We're going to create a game object. Game equals new game. So we're going to call the constructor for our game class. Lastly, for the game frame constructor, we need to add our game as well as our reset button to the frame. So at the end, before we set everything to be visible, this.add, we're going to add our reset button as well as our game. This.add game. Okay, so the constructor for GameFrame is now done. Let's head to the action performed method. So if somebody clicks on our reset button, this is what we're gonna do. If e.getSource, we're going to check to see if the action event is equal to our reset button. If getSource is equal to our reset button, that means somebody clicked our reset button, so they would like to reset the game. We're going to refer to this game frame, and we're going to remove our current game that we have. And we're going to construct a new one. Game equals new game. And we can create a new game by calling the game constructor to construct a new game for us. And we'll need to add the game to our frame, this.addGame. All right, well, let's run this just to test things. So we have our reset button on the left-hand side, and our game panel will be on the right-hand side, but we currently cannot see it. So this is where our game normally would be, but we're not actually going to create a full game, but we'll probably want some sort of visual representation just so that we know that our reset button is working. So what I'm thinking for this video is that every time we click this reset button, we'll generate a new game panel that has a random background color. Sound good to you guys? All right, let's try it. So within our game class, normally for whatever game you're creating, the code for your game will go here. Code for game goes here. And we will declare all the components that we'll need for our game. So we're just going to generate a random background color instead of creating a full-fledged game. So let's create an instance of the random class. We'll just declare our random instance, and then we'll finish instantiating this within the constructor. So within the constructor of our game, random equals new random. And we'll also need to generate a random color for this example. So one way in which we can do that is to generate some random RGB values. RGB values have a range between 0 and 255, so we would like to generate a random number between that range. So let's say int r for the amount of red that we would like for our color, equals random.nextInt, and within the nextInt method, we're going to pass in 256. That will give us a random number between 0 and 255. And we'll need to repeat the process for green and blue. So int g for green equals random.nextInt 256, and repeat the process for int b for blue. We'll need to finish creating our game panel that we have. So at the end, this.setSize, and I will set this to 500 by 500. That will give us a square. And set a location, this.setLocation, 100 by 0 would be good. And lastly, we need to set the background color with the random values that we generated. This.setBackground, new color, and with the arguments, we're going to pass in our values of R, G, and B. And then we should be good. We have one issue though, and let me explain. So this is our make-believe game that we have. It's just a random color on a background. So when we click this reset button, it's going to dispose of the current game panel that we have and generate a new one via the constructor that we have. However, nothing appears to happen when we click on this reset button. What we need to do is actually move our frame that we have. So we don't want to have to do this every single time. We want to update the components on our game frame. So there's one line of code that we can add to do that for us. So within the action performed method, there is just one line that we need to add that will update the components of our game frame whenever we make a change. So at the end, we'll add swing utilities dot update component tree UI. And we would like to update this. This refers to our game frame that we have. So then when we click our reset button, this will generate a new game panel for us. And normally you would have the code for your game that you have within probably some sort of constructor. So basically we're just disposing of the current instance that we have and recalling the constructor one more time. Well, everybody, that's how to create a reset button for your game or other application in Java. If you would like a copy of this code, I will post this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's how to create a reset button in Java. Hey, you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.